New tonight, local court records released this evening show a Louisville woman has filed an emergency protective order against the current Cleveland Cavalier and former UK basketball star Rajon Rondo of Louisville.
NBA player Rajon Rondo and his girlfriend were in an altercation with a woman on a parking lot, and the whole thing was caught on camera.
Former Celtics maestro Rajon Rondo finds himself in hot water, but not for a missed free throw or a botched pass. No, this time it's serious. Rondo was arrested in Indiana, sending shockwaves through the basketball community. Rajon Rondo, the Wizard of Assists, is now making headlines for all the wrong reasons. But what exactly went down? Today, we're diving deep into every detail of this unexpected turn of events. So stick around, because we're about to unravel the mystery behind Rondo's latest chapter, The Rise. But first, who exactly is Rajon Rondo? Born on February 22, 1986, this Kentucky native quickly made a name for himself as a basketball prodigy. From his high school days at Eastern to his time at Oak Hill Academy, Rondo's talent was undeniable, and it didn't stop there. He became a force during his college days at Kentucky, catching the attention of NBA scouts across the country. In 2006, Rondo's dreams became a reality when he was drafted by the Phoenix Suns and subsequently traded to the Boston Celtics. It was here that he truly made his mark on the NBA. Rondo spent over 9 seasons with the Celtics, becoming a household name. Winning titles and earning all-star nods, he solidified his reputation as one of the league's best point guards. But his legacy extends far beyond individual accolades. He's a 2-time NBA champion, securing his first ring with the Celtics in 2008 and adding another jewel to his crown with the Los Angeles Lakers in 2020. His ability to elevate his game on the grandest stage solidifies his status as one of the game's true winners. He's among the only 2 players to clinch championships with both the Celtics and the Lakers, a feat that cements his status among the game's legends. With his lightning-fast passes and defensive prowess, he became a crucial component of the Celtics' championship-winning team in 2008. Rondo's legacy was etched in Celtics lore. What set him apart was that he was a warrior with an unyielding spirit. He lacked the flashy athleticism of other point guards, but his hustle, basketball IQ, and sheer heart propelled him to greatness. He wasn't just a player. He was an extension of a coach, a strategist who could outsmart opponents with his knowledge of the game. And when the pressure was on, Rondo thrived, becoming one of the best floor generals of his generation. His partnership with legends like Ray Allen and coaches like Doc Rivers and Rick Carlisle brought out the best in everyone around him. His presence raised the performance of every team he played for. This was especially true in the high-stakes playoffs. Whether it was setting up teammates with pinpoint passes or making crucial defensive stops, Rondo was a difference maker when it mattered most. His numbers speak for themselves. An impressive career spanning 16 years with averages of 9.8 points, 4.5 rebounds, and 7.9 assists per game. Throughout his career, Rondo faced a share of challenges from injuries to criticism, but he never let anything hold him back. He once said, "I think if you look on the entirety of my career, I've always been able to perform at a high level, given obviously I've had a couple of injuries and setbacks the last couple of seasons. But other than that, I think I've always risen to the occasion and played pretty well in my career." He played for the Mavericks, Kings, Bulls, Pelicans, Lakers, Hawks, Clippers, and the Cavaliers. At each, he showed his ability to adapt and lead. But now there is a dark cloud that threatens to tarnish his legacy and overshadow his remarkable career. The incident.
This afternoon, former NBA basketball player Rajon Rondo is out on bond after being arrested in Indiana.
Officials say the 37-year-old was allegedly driving recklessly and was pulled over by a trooper.
The 2-time NBA champion found himself in the spotlight for all the wrong reasons. It was a routine traffic stop that turned into a nightmare for Rondo. His Tesla caught the attention of authorities for erratic driving, reportedly clocking speeds over 100 miles per hour. What should have been a minor infraction quickly got worse. Officers smelled marijuana. As officers searched the vehicle, they found a loaded 9mm gun. They also found a small amount of marijuana and drug paraphernalia. The discovery of the firearm raised further concerns, particularly in the light of Rondo's legal history and the presence of a protective order against him. An active protective order was in place. Previous incidents were on record. Rondo's possession of a firearm broke his court order and could have serious consequences. He was booked on multiple charges: possession of paraphernalia, possession of marijuana, and unlawful possession of a firearm. And despite being released on bond, the damage to his reputation is already done. But Rondo is no stranger to controversy. He is known as a skilled point guard on the court, but it's a different story off the court. In 2022, he found himself in hot water when a Louisville woman filed for an emergency protective order against him. Rondo, supposedly playing video games with a child, lost his cool over a simple request for the child to do some laundry. The situation spun out of control. He unleashed a sequence of destruction in the house, smashing objects, and even drove his car on the lawn. But it got worse. The woman alleged that Rondo even made chilling threats against her life, including a terrifying statement, "You're dead." She went on to describe the harrowing scene where Rondo, armed with a gun, instilled fear in the child present, leaving them visibly shaken. Instead of dialing 911, the woman reached out to former interim Louisville Metro Police Chief Yvette Gentry for help. But even with law enforcement on the scene, Rondo's defiance knew no bounds, refusing entry and escalating the tension. The woman, fearing for her safety and that of her child, sought refuge in her own home, locking herself in with the kids. But Gentry eventually told her Rondo had left. The woman wrote in the EPO, "I am extremely fearful for my safety and for the safety of my children. Rajon has a history of volatile, erratic, explosive behavior. I am beyond fearful that Rajon will return and attempt to harm myself or the children and make good on his threats to end my life." The legal system acted fast. It granted the woman an emergency protective order against Rondo just 2 days after the alleged incident. The judge's orders were clear. Rondo was to stay away from her and surrender his firearms. She also urged the court to require anger management classes, counseling, and a mental health evaluation for Rondo. The protective order was dismissed in June 2022 after both parties seemingly reached an agreement. However, the peace was short-lived as another emergency protective order was filed against Rondo by the same woman in March 2023. Once again, the courts intervened, but the cycle of legal battles continued. Eventually, the case ended in an agreed order in August 2023. Implications. It's not often that the basketball world finds itself caught in the eye of a legal storm, but that's exactly where we are right now. Rajon Rondo is facing some serious legal trouble that could spell disaster for his career. As a respected player with skills for days, the negative spotlight on his arrest could slam the door on future opportunities in the game. Just like when it seemed Rondo was riding high on a wave of success, this bombshell dropped. Earlier this year, 2024, he was honored as a hometown hero by the Greater Louisville Pride Foundation. But now, with this shocking turn of events, it seems like his once gleaming legacy is in jeopardy of tarnish. But in a surprising twist, Rondo's legal team is pulling out all the stops in defense of their client. They're arguing that the charge of unlawful possession of a firearm violates Rondo's Second Amendment rights. Rondo isn't backing down without a fight. Despite facing pressure from prosecutors, he rejected plea agreement offers and is gearing up to stand trial on April 25th. It's a bold move that signals his confidence in the strength of his legal argument. But what's shaking up the courtroom is the recent wave of legal rulings challenging gun possession laws. Rondo's attorney points to a key appeals court ruling in Mississippi. It declared laws against firearm possession by people with prior felonies unconstitutional. It's a game changer that could tip the scales in Rondo's favor. His legal team isn't just relying on recent rulings, they're invoking the nation's historical tradition of firearm regulation. According to Wren, the gun charge against Rondo fails to align with this tradition, adding another layer of complexity to an already fascinating case. With rulings shaking up the legal landscape, the tide may be turning in Rondo's favor. Could this be the break he needs to come out on top? Only time will tell. And speaking of facing the court head-on, you won't want to overlook our next video. We dissect the gripping tale of Mikey Williams, so if you're ready to delve into the highs and lows of basketball stardom, hit that play button.